Thanks everybody for being here. It's just an honor to have all of you sharing your time with us this afternoon. And I don't know about you guys, but like I feel my cup runneth over just from what I've heard today alone. So thank you, Chief. Your comments resonate immensely. Everything from your sense of community to your understanding of place. And what I really appreciate is that concept of generations all needing the same sort of support through their issues and their challenges and maintaining what matters to us most as people. So that was a very important message that I took from what you said today, and thank you for that. And I don't know, I think the mayor has since left the room, but he is a true resilience champion for our city, and I know Smita, I think, and Uthman, where are you? There you are. Just hearing the mayor speak sets the tone for our whole community, frankly. And so it is the community that we do the work that we do for and with. And that's what inspires us most. So there's been a lot of chatting and a lot of information. And I think according to the program, in 10 minutes, you're all released to go and work with the Collab Circle team on these exciting topics that the mayor and Smita have both briefly touched on. So from an agenda point of view, I'm going to just go like burn through this super fast now and get you off talking, because you don't need to hear about anything I have to say. We want to hear from you. That's what this launch into phase two is really about. And just on behalf of the team, we did meet in March of last year, and we gathered many of you to that room, and you overwhelmed us with your perceptions of resilience, your understanding of our community, your understanding of what drives our community and its issues, and in fact, your energy and your interest in making a difference going forward. And so from that time, the team really took the time to dig into some of those pieces from a research perspective and built the PRA. And from that PRA, we were able to identify what you're going to hear about shortly as the key topics we want to dig into. And so I just wanted to acknowledge the team. First of all, there wasn't the whole team. There was three of us, I think, or four, working with you at the agenda setting workshop. And then we had the opportunity to add to the team and then do that work. So if you're wondering why it took us this long to get to this point, it's because of the care that was taken in really looking at the issues in our city and then taking the time to inform our current council when they first joined us in the fall about those issues and to participate in setting us up for the next four-year business cycle. So the excitement today is really about embracing, launching into this discussion with what you have to say about our community. And I've had this slide up now. You know enough about the fact that we are part of the 100 Resilient City Network. I think most of you may have, if you're not by now, become familiar with the City Resilience Framework, which is a wheel with four drivers and 12 dimensions. All of our preliminary resilience area assessment spoke to all of the dimensions on this wheel and really does include our community as partners in managing some of the drivers on the wheel. You'll learn more about this if you don't know about it this afternoon and as we work in the collaboration circles going forward. That's a picture from our agenda setting workshop. You might see yourself in that photo. And what we learned from you were all of these dots on the resilience wheel, and each dot represents many, many, many tables of inputs. And we really learned that as a community, we do have several strengths. And it really is about our connectiveness with one another. And in fact, Smita and Uthman's predecessor, Katja, the first thing when she came to Calgary and walked around our community with us and spoke with us, she said, I have never seen a city in the 100 Resilient Cities Network with the sense of community spirit that Calgary has. And I would say that's perhaps still true today. You're both nodding, so we'll take that as a yes. And really, we do also have some challenges, and that is, as the mayor mentioned, looking at our economic prosperity, making sure that we are an inclusive community for all, and supporting and looking at those natural assets that we have in abundance in our community, and how do we ensure that we can preserve those wherever possible and have them help us in managing some of the shocks that we have recently seen in abundance as well. From that agenda setting workshop, we met with focus groups, we participated in school conversations, we had lots of workshop participation activities in the community and with some of you as partners. We connected with several internal and external stakeholders, internal to the city, where many of the other services that our city supports, such as customer service and communications. The city has done just a wide breadth of discussion with the community about the things that matter most to their quality of life, and all of that input was included in our PRA. We worked with our colleagues at the Calgary Economic Development and learned from your focus groups as well, the climate resilience strategy activities that were underway. So we tried to branch out and really hear all of the work that was going on and learn from that work. And then we came up with this very massive page full of lines and numbers, which really helped us. If you take the wheel and put it on a line, you can look at it from this perspective. And we learned that this concept of making sure there was enough for all in our community and understanding where there are people who have needs and how do we reach those people to ensure their voice is included in some of our decision making became a top priority for us. The economic situation in Calgary and the unemployment and the inability for many skilled people in our community who no longer have employment to translate those skills into new work became a priority focus area. Looking at our engaged communities, I spoke to that. The economic prosperity, looking at our natural and man-made assets, we really started to understand that as we look at additional shocks of climate change and weather-related events, how can we use the community that we have to manage some of those and anticipate and absorb some of those shocks, and where can we reinforce some of that investment? And so that brought us to a discussion on specific discovery areas. And these are not pretty slides, I promise you. They are much better and when you print them out as a document. and they're all available on the calgary.ca website. And this was something we prepared for council, which was called a placemat. The city's into placemats these days. There's no coffee stain on it yet. That's your job, put coffee stains on the placemat. But really on the left, it was aligning our resilience work and our understanding of where we need to focus with council's priorities and what the citizens have said to us. It was ensuring that we embedded the qualities of a resilient city as identified through 100 Resilient Cities and the AirUp Foundation into the thinking and bringing that lens to our thinking process at the city. And then at the bottom, we really wanted to honor the great work of several long-range visioning documents and thinking processes that our city has enjoyed. And the main one being the 100-year vision for Calgary of Imagine Calgary. So the bottom is actually a continuum. You heard Brad say, we've learned what has been a shock or stress to us as a community up to this point in time. What do we anticipate moving forward? And so the bottom right of this line really looks us out to that 100-year vision and helps us anticipate the types of stresses and shocks we may see coming to us. How do we prepare ourselves as a community for those things? So from there, you can see we identified four discovery areas, and you've heard the mayor reference them by name. And what we'd like to do today is really move into some of those collaboration circle discussions to get your inputs into how we can set some strategies and actions for these discovery areas and really build more on into the community and having the community involved in some of this work. These are the four. So, economic resilience is strengthening our economic drivers to be better prepared for stresses and shocks. And the program lead on this is the aforementioned Jason Cameron. Jason does bring with him some amazing emergency related type of resilience actions that have been undertaken in other communities impacted by shocks. And Jason's always been a community actualizer, as we know you to be. And he's been working very closely with Calgary Economic Development and the Economic Development Strategy. So we're looking really forward to moving forward in that partnership and really realizing some of those pieces identified in the strategy that CED's developed, as well as where the 100 Resilient Partners of 100 Resilient Cities can help us deep dive into some of our major issues. I'm going to abbreviate because of time. So you'll learn more about this in the collab circle with Jason. And this is the vision produced by CED. It's very innovative. Thank you, Court. Good work. Inclusive leadership and decision making. So we have a member on our team who has a prescriptive glasses, and they're called optimistic glasses, and her name is Jenny. Jenny, you are such a bright light, and we are so appreciative of your amazing way to see how we need to include everyone in our decision-making. And so Jenny is the program lead on inclusive leadership and decision-making. She's been doing some great work already in working with some of the members of the community that we have not historically been able to engage with. And she really, truly believes that if we have the inclusivity of diverse voices, we have a better resilience future. So this is high level, some of the questions, the future of relationships that Jenny wants to deep dive into, as well as how can we ensure that we are having that diverse representation when we have leadership opportunities in our community. So Jenny is the program lead for inclusivity and diversity. Environment resilience. Heather is our green team member. She is often not available because she's out of Wi-Fi area in a camping site somewhere on the weekend. And we are very appreciative of her ability to think through issues and such complex issues in such a thoughtful way. She has a quiet way of just connecting out into the community. And I think of you much as a tree. You're kind of solid and tall, but your roots span and your branches span. And so we really did feel as we did our PRA and talked about what we need to know more about our natural asset inventory as a community is what can we do to better understand how Mother Nature can support our community and how we can better support Mother Nature. So this is a whole focus on natural assets and making sure we better understand the role of these natural assets look going forward. And so these are the deep dive questions that Heather will participate in. And if I understand correctly, Heather, your colleague is the climate resilience team. So it's great we've got that connectivity occurring in place now. And that's the climate resilience alignment. And you'll all have a copy of this. You can look at the details of it later. Our infrastructure resilience. So I am the director of resilience and infrastructure. And the team that isn't here, maybe Scott, are you still here? No. They're so busy preparing for a council discussion next week that just was shared with us yesterday. no disrespect to anyone. It's just that's how we roll. But they are actually the other half of the resilience team, and we have worked very closely with our partners in emergency management and in the climate resilience team to understand the anticipated stresses and shocks that are coming to us in the future and how we need to preserve our critical infrastructure and really understand what our infrastructure assets mean to our community and how they're so integral to supporting service delivery going forward. And so the infrastructure resilience team doesn't have a collab circle today for you to participate in. There will be an opportunity for that. That will be shared with you shortly. We just didn't have the capacity to do that much more work on this day today. But that's an important piece of work that is very connected, of course. What I wanted you to know about the infrastructure investment is that we've already been working with council and through our chief resilience officer, Brad, as our executive sponsor with the Infrastructure Calgary Steering Committee team, and helping council understand the importance of prioritizing our capital infrastructure and ensuring there's a really resilience lens embedded in that. So that's these are principles approved now by council that occurred in, was that May? I think it was May. And these are guiding our capital infrastructure investments for the next 4 years. You may have heard about this three conversations, One Calgary. So One Calgary is the next four-year business planning cycle. And what I want you to know is that this next launch as we go into phase two is where, as community, you get to have another avenue to participate in sharing your ideas with council and with administration about resilience. And so I just wanted to put this up quickly to say we've been, as I mentioned, tying into that One Calgary work for the next 4 years, and the resilience team will continue to bring that resilience conversation to the council table through our role in corporate governance at the city. So that is our service area, and we will continue this resilience dialogue internally and with our community, and we are your stewards to do that. If I don't see, there's Lorna. Lorna and Adonica, who's hiding over there. Come on in for 2 seconds. And Afshin. These three ladies are sort of the hub of the resilience work, along with Jennifer. And Jennifer is our business strategist. So Jennifer, Lorna, Adonica, and Afshin, honestly, if you have any resilience question about anything, they are your go-tos. And we are so incredibly fortunate to have the four of you supporting the program leads as they move into the community. And without your pioneering work to even get our application submitted, we wouldn't be here. So I wanted to, can we take a moment to acknowledge the three of you in particular? And so the blue box on the left is because of that team, and the blue box on the right is because of the whole team with the addition of our program leads. So that's just a little bit of who's who in the zoo in case you were wondering, who am I talking to today? All right. So this is our process. So we've done the listen, the learn. We're moving into the discussion and the planning, and you're a part of that. We thank you for your participation in that. And then we are planning to bring a resilient strategy to council quarter one of next year and then move into implementation over the next 3 years as part of our next service plan and budget. And that's just to give you the what's happening next. Okay, I really talked too long. I'm sorry about that. There's two things I wanted to say. One is the mayor mentioned the silent floods. And when I saw Katie here at one point, maybe you're gone now too. Okay. Are you there? Oh, you are there. And Tom's there too. And there's a few directors in the room. This morning, there's a group of directors that are preparing for the next four-year plan. And one of our discussions was around supporting the team that supports the community who are coming to the city to say, I need some help being able to afford things like my bus pass. So I look at that lineup of people on the third floor, and that is the silent flood. That is the group of people in our community who need their government to be nimble and to be supportive and need the services that we offer to them. And so I don't just think about the shocks that our community experiences. I truly do visualize that community that needs their government to be there and their community members to also be supportive with things like arts and culture and festivities and just vibrancy in our community. So that was number one. Number two was you spoke, Chief, of nature. And it is this five-year anniversary of the flood. And I remember being at an open house after the flood event, and this lovely lady, she was quite shooken up by the impact to her life and her community. And she just wanted someone to listen to her. And so I thought, okay, I'll just listen. And what she wanted to talk to me about was she said, I knew something was up when the mother beaver that lives in her beaver dam at the foot of the river near my home started hauling out her beaver pups and carrying them up the hill because she knew the lodge itself was no longer a safe home for her family. And that has stuck with me for 5 years because really that's what resilience is all about. It's about us being able to take care of those we love and keep them safe. And so let's be aware of the signals in our community. Let's keep working on the journey together. We have an inspired group of people who want to do the work. We have an inspiring community to help us in that work. And I thank you for your time and your energy as we go forward together. Thanks.